Class 6 Level 2 SOF NSO. Science question number 1. An object O is situated between two plane mirrors M1 and M2 as shown in the given figure. Possible image of the object O is? When an object is placed between two plane mirrors, multiple images are formed due to reflection. The first image is formed by the reflection of the object O in mirror M1. The second image is formed by the reflection of the object in mirror M2. Then M2 reflects the image and can be seen in I2. The second image is formed by the reflection of the object O in mirror M2. Then that image reflected by M1, and like that multiple images are formed. So one major possible image of the object O can be at I2. Science question number 2. The ratchet head of a distance measuring instrument as shown in the given figure turns by 9 revolutions. Find the distance between the anvil and the spindle. Also, how many revolutions does the thimble revolve? Assume that distance moved by the spindle for every 2 revolutions is 1 millimeter. Distance moved by the spindle for every 2 revolutions is 1 millimeter. Distance moved by the spindle for 1 revolution is 1 millimeter divided by 2, that is 0.5 mm. Distance covered by the spindle for 9 revolutions of ratchet head is equal to 0.5 into 9, that is 4.5 mm. Number of revolutions of the thimble. The thimble is directly attached to the ratchet head, so it revolves the same number of times as the ratchet head. Therefore, number of revolutions of the thimble is equal to 9. Science question number 3. The distance time graph of a particle is shown here. The corresponding speed time graph of the particle is? We know that speed is equal to distance by time. This graph shows the distance versus time relationship for a particle. From time is equal to 0 to 2, the distance increases linearly, indicating uniform motion with constant speed. Speed is constant, so the speed time graph is a horizontal straight line. From time equal to 2 to 4, the graph shows slope decreases progressively, indicating particle is slowing down, meaning its speed is decreasing over time. Speed decreases steadily to 0. The speed time graph would slope downward and end at 0 at time is equal to 4. Science question number 4. Consider 4 identical bulbs. B1, B2, B3 and B4. These are connected in the manner as shown in the given figure. When one of the 4 bulbs, B3, has blown off, then consider the following statements. Statement 1. Brightness of the bulb B1, B2 and B4 increases. In series circuit, the current flows through all the components sequentially. If B3 is blown out, open circuit, no current can flow through B1, B3 or B4. This means the series circuit is interrupted and B1, B4 also become inactive. As a result, the parallel circuit containing B1 and B2 cannot function because B1 is inactive. The entire circuit will stop functioning because of the failure of B3 in the series connection. Interrupts the flow of current throughout the circuit. So both statement 1 and statement 2 are false. Science question number 5. Geeta placed 3 objects 1, 2 and 3 as shown in the given figure. She observed a bright spot of light at object 2, but object 3 would not get any spot. Then object 1 is transparent. It allows light to pass through it. Object 2 is opaque. It reflects the light that is passed through object 1, creating the bright spot. Object 3 does not receive any light, either because it is out of path of the light or is blocked by object 2. So it may be either transparent or opaque or translucent material. Science question number 6. Let ball P and ball Q both release from point O of their respective frictionless ramps as shown in the given figure. The time taken by both the balls to reach point O is recorded. If both the balls have traveled the same distance, then which of the following statement is or are correct about the time taken by two balls? At the start, downward acceleration of P is more. As path length is same, P will take lesser time. Ball Q takes longer time than ball P. Science question number 7. The given graph shows the motion of an object over a period of time between two positions x and y. Which of the following graph correctly lists the type of motion between various positions? Curvilinear motion. Curvilinear motion is motion along a curved path. Periodic motion. Motion that repeats at regular intervals. Rectilinear motion. Motion along a straight line. From 1 to 3 it's curvilinear motion. Then from 3 to 4 is periodic motion and from 4 to 5 it's rectilinear motion. Science question number 8. A heater, a fan and a bulb are connected to 15 volt battery as shown in the given figure. The fan with a resistor R has a potential difference of 6 volt across it and a current of 3 ampere is flowing through the fan. The bulb has current of 2 ampere flowing through it. Select the correct statement. From the circuit, the fan and heater are in series and the bulb branches off in a parallel. Given fan current I is equal to 3 ampere. Fan voltage is equal to 6 V. Fan resistance is equal to... Now let us calculate the fan resistance, that is R, that is given. Using Ohm's law, R is equal to V by I, which is equal to 6 volt by 3 ampere, which is equal to 2 ohms, which is equal to R. Similarly, bulb current I is equal to 2 ampere, bulb voltage is equal to 6 voltage. Bulb voltage is same as a fan voltage since they are in parallel connection. So, bulb resistance is equal to 6 by 2, which is equal to 3 ohms. Heater current is the sum of fan current plus bulb current, which is equal to 5 ampere. Heater and fan share the voltage of 15 voltage. Heater voltage is equal to total voltage minus fan voltage, which is equal to 9 voltage. So, using this, heater resistance is equal to 9 by 5 ohms. Given fan resistance is equal to 2 ohms, which is equal to R. The voltage across the bulb is 6 voltage. Yes, this is true. And its resistance is 2R. Here the value of R is equal to 2 ohms. Given resistor of bulb is equal to 2 into R, which is equal to 2 into 2, that is 4 ohms, which is not equal to 3 ohms, because the resistance of bulb is 3 ohms. The voltage across the bulb is 6 voltage. Yes, this is true. And its resistance is 3 by 2 R. Here the value of R is equal to 2. Given resistance of the bulb is 3 by 2 into R, which is equal to 3 ohms. So, it is correct. The voltage across the heater is 9 voltage. Yes, it's true. And its resistance is 2R. Given resistance of heater is equal to 2 into R, which is equal to 4 ohm. But the resistance of heater is 9 by 5 ohms. So, this is wrong. The voltage across the heater is 9 voltage. Yes, it's true. And its resistance is 9 by 10 R. Given resistance of heater is 9 by 10 into R, which is equal to 9 by 5 ohms. The resistance of heater is 9 by 5 ohms. So, this is true. Second option and fourth option are true. Science question number 9. Consider a light steel bar and a light iron bar which are attracted to a magnet as shown in the given figure. What will possibly happen when the magnet is removed? The magnet magnetizes the steel bar, but once the magnet is removed, the steel bar will lose its magnetism because steel is typically not a permanent magnet. The iron bar is not magnetized on its own, but likely magnetized due to the interaction with the steel bar. Once the steel bar loses its magnetism, the iron bar will also lose its magnetism. Thus, both the steel bar and iron bar will lose their magnetism after the magnet is removed. Science question number 10. Suhana suspended a bar magnet and piece of magnetic material on each end of the plastic pole. She then placed a thin wood between the two objects. Which of the following diagrams would correctly represent the situation? The magnet attracts magnetic material and try to stick with the magnet. So, the correct possible situation would be the D option. Science question number 11. Identify the possible set of polarities when magnetizing a steel bar by stroking method as shown in the given figure and select the correct statements. By single stroking method, if P is South Pole, then Q is North Pole, then X is North Pole and Y is South Pole. Or if P is North Pole, then Q is South Pole and X is South Pole and Y is North Pole. So, the polarities can be second and fourth option. Science question number 12. Consider the four diagrams. The correct option for the brightness of the bulbs in increasing order is: a bulb's brightness depends on the power P it consumes, which is given by the formula. Power is equal to voltage into current. We know current is equal to voltage by resistance. So power is equal to voltage into voltage by resistance. Batteries in parallels provide the same voltage as a single battery while increasing current capacity. Batteries in series, the total voltage is the sum of individual voltages while current capacity remains the same. Components like bulbs in a series, the total voltage is the sum of individual voltage drops across each component while the same current flows through all. Components like bulbs in parallel, the voltage across each component is the same, while the total current is the sum of individual currents flowing through each branch. Let voltage of each cell is V and resistor of each bulb is R. In case 1, power is equal to 16 V square by R. In case 2, power is equal to V square by R. In case 3, power is equal to 4 V square by R. In case 4, power is equal to 9 V square by R. Therefore, the increasing order of brightness is the same as the D option. Science question number 13. A person stands still while a plane mirror is wheeled away from him at the rate of 2 meter per second as shown in the given figure. How fast does the person see his image moving away? In a plane mirror, the image is formed at an equal distance behind the mirror as the object in front of it. Therefore, as the mirror moves away from the person, the image also moves away from the person at the twice rate of the mirror's motion. So, the answer is the C option. Science question number 14. A few materials are listed in the box. Which of the following options correctly classify these materials as flammable and non-flammable? Petrol, kerosene, coconut oil are flammable, while the others are non-flammable. Science question number 15. Which of the following methods of separation is based on the difference in densities of particles? Centrifugation. Science question number 16. Match column 1 and column 2 and select the correct option from the given quotes. A heterogeneous mixture is a mixture in which the components are not uniformly distributed, while a homogeneous mixture is a mixture in which the components are uniformly distributed throughout. Chalk water mixture is a heterogeneous solid liquid mixture. Air is a homogeneous gaseous mixture. Smoke is a solid gas mixture. Glucose solution is a homogeneous solid liquid mixture. And a fuzzy drink is a gas liquid mixture. Science question number 17. Which of the following statement is true regarding a saturated solution? A saturated solution is a solution that contains the maximum amount of solute that can dissolve in a given amount of solvent at a specific temperature and pressure. Any additional solute added to the solution will not dissolve and will remain as a solid or undissolved material. In a saturated solution, the maximum amount of solute is dissolved at a given temperature. However, increasing the temperature usually increases the solubility of most solutes, allowing more solute to dissolve. Science question number 18. Select the option which correctly identifies substances W, X, Y and Z respectively. First, we'll take W. W can be talcum powder, frosted glass or honey. Only talcum powder is opaque and insoluble in water. So, we can take the option A. Insulator and floats on water, wooden block. Transparent and soluble in water, oxygen. Ductile and denser than water, iron. Science question number 19. Select the correct statement about the methods of separation depicted in the figure 1 and figure 2. To separate mustard oil from water, you can use decantation or a separating funnel as they are effective for separating immiscible liquids, liquids that do not mix like oil and water. So, method 2 can be used to separate mustard oil from water. Science question number 20. Properties of a material X are listed as good conductor of heat, light in weight, and strong, chemically unreactive. X is most suitable for making cooking utensils. Science question number 21. Fill in the blanks by selecting an appropriate option. Threshing is used to separate stalks from grains. Separating funnel is based on immiscibility of liquids. Sieving is based on difference in size of particles, while centrifugation is used to separate platelets from blood. Science question number 22. Match column 1 and column 2 and select the correct option from the given codes. Toothpick is made of wood, belt is made of leather, temple bell is made out of metal, window panes are made of frosted glass. Science question number 23. Study the given flowchart and identify X, Y, and Z. Clearly, Z is water. X cannot be sugar. Sugar cannot be separated from water through filter. In the B option cannot be the correct option because water is not a solid. C option cannot be the correct option because Y cannot be sand. Sand can be separated from water through sedimentation. Science question number 24. Identify T, U, V, and W from the given information. T can be muddy water, U can be wheat flour and bran, V can be salt solution water and acetone, honey in water. W can be husks and grains. Science question number 25. Select the correct match of material, its property and its usage. A cannot be the option because wood is not a conductor but an insulator. B cannot be the option because book is not malleable. C can be the option. D cannot be because rubber is not used for cooking purposes. So the answer is C. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit the like button and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.